Lisa was a movie queen before she'd achieved the age of sweet 16. Long before Cagney threw those girls about, little Louisa tossed her curls about. Later when the talkies came, the whole world resounded to her fame. Each time she married, every daily paper carried headlines blazing her name. Not only headlines, but photographs and interviews. Everything she did was news that held the world in thrall. Some say she read lines better than Marlena could. No other entertainer could compete with her at all. But regardless of the fact that she could sing and dance and act, and owned furniture that wasn't little rockery, and regardless of her gems, which were hers, not MGM's, her life was one long mockery. Louisa was terribly lonely. Success brought her naught but despair. She derived little fun from the Oscars she'd won, and none from her home in Bel Air. She said she was weary of living on this bestial terrestrial plane. When friends came to visit, their hands she would clutch, crying, "Tell me, why is it I suffer so much? Oh, if only, if only, if only my life wasn't quite such a strain." And soon after that, she was terribly lonely all over again. Louisa was terribly lonely. Louisa was terribly sad. It appears that the cheers that had rung in her ears for years had been driving her mad. She sobbed when men offered her sables, and moaned when they gave her champagne. She remarked to her groom on their honeymoon night, as he tenderly kissed her and switched off the light, "Oh, if only, if only, if only I'd flung myself out of that plane." And the very next day, she was terribly lonely all over again. Louisa was terribly lonely. The girl had no fun. Louisa was tired of it all. Not a call from anyone. She gazed like a dazed, frustrated sphinx at 108 mutated minks. And she wrung her hands and she beat her breast, crying, "My, my, my, I'm so depressed." Nobody knew the trouble she'd seen. Nobody knew but you know who the tribulations of a movie queen. So farewell to lovely Louisa. We just let life tease her. Let's leave her searching in vain to find someone to explain why destiny singled her out to be only lonely over and over again.